Hey guys, in this video we will build a Python powered Excel file. Let me show you what I mean by this. When I click this button, a Python code will be executed. For a demo, let's assume the following use case. I have a bunch of Excel files, and from those I only want to extract certain values. For instance, from the report sheets, I want the total and average sales. And then from the datasheet, I also want to extract the total quantities. So back in my workbook, I have inputted the folder to my Excel files here. Below that, I have created a table where I specify which cells I want to retrieve. When I now click this button, a Python script will be executed. Once done, a new workbook will be created for me. And this new workbook now looks like this, with all the values in a nicely structured format, which I could now, for example, upload to a database. This is, of course, just one use case. The main purpose of this video is to show you how to integrate Python into Excel. And we are not talking about the new Python in Excel functionality, which Microsoft recently released. That new functionality is great for data analysis, but not so much for Excel automation. To automate Excel, we will be using xlwings. And with that said, let's dive in and create this workbook from scratch. First things first, we need to install the required packages. Open your command prompt or terminal and use pip install xlwings. Additionally, to scrape the data, we will also need OpenPyXL. And to transform the data, we also need pandas. Alright, once you have those packages installed, we will create an xlwings quick start project. In my case, I'm already in the correct folder on my desktop. Here I will type xlwings quick start, followed by the name of the project, so for example Excel Scraper. Additionally, you want to include the argument standalone, just like I did here. Once executed, xlwings will create a new folder for us in the directory from where we ran the command. In this folder, you will find a Python and Excel file. Let me copy both of those files and paste them next to my input folder. Okay, and with that, I can now delete the initial folder. Next, I will open the workbook and insert a button to see if everything is working. For that, navigate to the Developer tab. If you do not see the tab, right-click on an empty space on the ribbon and select Customize the ribbon. Next, activate the Developer tab and confirm your action by clicking OK. With that in place, navigate to Insert and select a button. You can now draw the button onto your sheet. Afterwards, a new window will pop up where you want to select Sample Call. Alright, and now you can test things out by clicking on that button. Now, ideally, you shouldn't get an error like I did here. However, if you also get an error saying that the interpreter could not be found, you need to check the settings sheet. Here you can specify the path to your Python interpreter. To activate this settings sheet, you just need to remove the leading underscore. In my case, that fixed already the issue. However, if you are still receiving an error, check out the xlwings troubleshooting page, which I will link also below the video. So, when clicking the button, you should see Hello xlwings in cell A1. And if you click the button again, it should say Buy xlwings. And here's how it works. This button triggers a VBA macro. That macro then runs a Python code connected to your workbook. So let us take a look behind the scenes by opening the Visual Basic Editor. Within Module 1, you will see the sample call macro. This line looks a bit convoluted, but all it does is get the workbook name and then run the Python file in your workbook's directory. And you have this one Python function because you used the standalone argument in the beginning, which injected the xlwings module into the workbook. Next, let us take a look at the Python file. Here you can see the main function being called from Excel. The cool part is that you now have access to all the Excel objects and data here in Python. That means you can read and write values, just like in this example. Additionally, you could also create custom defined functions, but we will not talk about that in this video. Okay, now that our Excel workbook and Python code is connected, let's build the user interface for our Data Scraper app. For that, I will speed up the video. Now, the idea is as follows. Since we can access all the data in our Python code, we can build the entire user interface in Excel. This means all the settings and information we might need later on can be placed inside Excel. For our Data Scraper, I will define the input folder path up here. Below that, we will have a table where I will define which cells I want to scrape. Additionally, for the output file, I will also give this value a name. Now, you could leave it like this and tell Python to get the input folder path from cell C4, but we will make it more robust by using named ranges. To do this, select the cell you want to access later on and click into the name box. Here you can specify the name for the range. I will call mine input underscore folder. After that, just hit enter. Next, I will convert this cell range to a table. This makes it easier to convert it to a pandas data frame later on. So, under insert, select the table, and as my table has headers, I am going to tick this box here. Alright, and instead of table 1, I will rename it to table settings. Once done, you should now have two named ranges. The last piece of information we need is the folder path to the spreadsheets we want to scrape. To do this, right-click on the folder and select copy as path. Back in Excel, paste it into our named range and remove the quotation marks. Okay, and with that, let us move on to the fun part, which is formatting your spreadsheet. To spice things up, I will also add some emojis to my sheet using my own Excel add-in called Emojify. Here I just need to select a cell, choose an emoji, and the add-in will place it right into the cell. In the settings, you can also select where the emoji should be placed. For example, you could place them on the left, outside the cell. And of course, you can also insert multiple emojis in one go. And these emojis are just normal images, so you can easily remove them, resize them, and position them anywhere you want in the sheet. Or if you are feeling fancy, you can also group them with the button. If you are interested in the add-in, you can find more information in the link in the description box. Okay, and the last step before we move on to the Python code is to rename the sheet. I will call mine settings, and then I will save the workbook. Okay. And with that, let us now switch to the Python file. Here, we first want to import the packages we are going to use. Later, we will add a timestamp to the file name, so I'm going to import daytime from daytime. To deal with the different file and folder paths, I'm also going to import path from pathlib. For scraping the Excel data, we have installed OpenPyXL. And lastly, I will also import pandas_spd for the data transformation. With that in place, I'm going to delete the sample code up until the workbook caller. Okay, so within this workbook, we can now access our settings sheet, where we have our data. First, I'm going to transform our table into a pandas data frame. This means getting the Excel range of the table, and then transforming this range into a pandas data frame using the option method. Afterwards, I will get the input folder from our named range, and convert this string into a path object. As the next step, I will prepare an empty list to collect the values we are going to scrape later on. With that set up, I will get the list of all the Excel files from our input folder. Later, I also want to store the extracted data in an output folder. To create that folder, I will be using pathlib. And this output folder should be in my workbooks directory. Alright, with all that in place, we can now iterate over all the Excel files in my input folder. As a first step, we need to load the workbook using OpenPyXL so that we have access to the data. Next, we need to specify which data we want to access, and for that we have our settings table. As you remember, we converted that table to a pandas data frame, which now allows us to iterate over it and extract the output name, the sheet name, and the cell address from our table. Now that we have that information, we can use OpenPyXL again to read the values. First, I will specify the sheet. Within the particular sheet, we can pass in our cell address to retrieve the value. Alright, and now that we have the cell value, we can append it to our result list. In addition to the values, I will also append the current Excel file name, as well as the output name we defined in our table. After we have looped over all the Excel files, we can create our final spreadsheet using pandas. For that, we just need to pass in the result list and provide the column header names. As the last step, we need to save this data frame to our output folder. This means creating the output file path, and to avoid overwriting any existing files, adding a timestamp to the file name using the daytime module. Now that we have the file name, we can export the data frame. And for a better user experience, I will also notify the user with a message box once the results are saved. For that, we can use the alert method with a message and a title. Alright, and that is basically it. Now, I rushed a bit over the Python code, because let's be honest here, this whole code really depends on your specific use case. And of course, you can always turn to ChatGPT to generate the code for you based on your needs. For me, the main purpose was to show you how to hook up Python with Excel and get started with a practical use case. Okay, with that said, let me return to Excel. If I now click the button, we should see our message box. This also means we should now have an output folder where I can find the data we extracted from the different spreadsheets. Alright guys, and here's our data. The cool part, as I mentioned, is that you have complete flexibility with Excel. This means if you need to extend or shorten the table, you can easily do this. And of course, you can adjust the cell and sheet names or the input folder path without touching your Python code again. This flexibility can be also very useful if you are building Python tools for your coworkers. Okay guys, I hope you liked the video and got some automation ideas for your own task. As always, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.